ジャーミーさん、シンクファーブからいらっしゃってます。セットアップしますので少々お待ちください。Thank you, Kengo, Desmond. Good afternoon, everybody. Ohayou gozaimasu. Konnichiwa. Watashi wa Jeremy-san desu. Let's see, Nihongo wa chotto dake dekimasu. That's it. That's all you're gonna get.
通訳はいらないと思うんですけど、日本語ちょっとできますのことです。
I just got off the plane, just a few hours ago, so please bear with me. It's nice and... The lighting is nice in here, so we'll try and spice up the mood. Very exciting space I'm talking about today. It's a blockchain in the manufacturing supply chain, particularly because of its revolutionary implications. There's as I'll go through in the context of the presentation. Sorry, I'm going too fast.
Okay. 今日、朝ですね、6時に東京に着きました。で、会場もとても、まあ、素晴らしく。で、今日特に話すのはマニファクチャリングとサプライチェーンにおけるブロックチェーンの活用についてです。
But essentially the question we want to answer is how can blockchain technology support simpler creation of commercial agreements while mobilizing precious big data?
特に今回話したいのはそのブロックチェーン技術を使っていかにその契約というものをシンプルにしていくかということです。
And how is blockchain technology going to revolutionize the manufacturing?Supply chain. We hear a lot about supply chain, but the manufacturing supply chain in particular, and why is that important for the world economy? I like to put it in the context of the economy.
特に、ブロックチェーンを使ってどうやってその製造業を良くしていくかというところについて話したいと思ってます。
And of course, what is SyncFab and what brings us all here today? So a very important feature of the blockchain is the incentive alignment principle or Satoshi Nakamoto's incentive alignment principle and which we believe serves as the grease to the gears that is going to move, that will transform the manufacturing supply chain as we know it, accelerating the ramp up to the much talked about fourth industrial revolution.
特に重要になるのがその Satoshi Nakamoto さんが提唱したその、ブロックチェーンの理論を基づいて製造業におけるインダストリー 4.0 っていうところですね。それと絡めてお話したいと思ってます。
So putting it in context, the global economy is currently about 75 trillion US dollars, as was released in a report by the World Bank and the World Economic Forum. And for the first time, the world economy is growing the fastest it's been ever since the financial crisis.
ワールドエコノミック世界経済フォーラムだったり、世界銀行が発表したアナウンスによると、2008年のその、ファイナンシャルクライシスの後ですね、急速に、エコノミー経済は成長しています。
And this is important because essentially the global economy is currently at full capacity. And this has tremendous implications for the supply chain.
成長してるんですけども、キャパシティ的にはもうフルになっていて、これをどうサプライチェーンに、考えるべきか話したいと思います。
Now, in the same report, the World Economic Forum highlighted that the key to sustainable growth going forward is going to be productivity. Most of this growth that we're currently experiencing is demand-side stimulus spending from the governments, as well as easy credit.
持続的な成長をするためには、プロダクティビティ、生産性が必要です。今はどちらかというと、その政府側からのディマンド、がまあ大きいので、そこに対応するということで、できていますが、プロダクティビティというのを上げることが必要です。
So, what's interesting to note in light of that is the need for productivity growth drivers going forward in light of what the World Economic Forum's pronouncement was?
And the drop-off in manufacturing activity since 1995, where if you look at this graph, it essentially bottomed at the time of the financial crisis.
製造業の生産性というのは1995年からですね、どんどん急速に落ちています。で、2008年の、リーマンショックの時にボトムに入って、まあ、今ちょっと上がってるんですが、下降傾向にあるということには変わりありません。
And so, just following the financial crisis, started to pick up just a little bit, because what was happening is the economy was starting to wean itself off the financial engineering and the services, realizing that, well, we needed to be productive again.And productivity, almost by definition, is manufacturing.
2008年の、後にですね、まあ、金融危機を受けて、もっと我々って生産性高くなければならないということに気づいて、生産性が少し上がりました。
So, since the world economy is growing at the fastest rate since the financial crisis, it's obviously it's also a very good time for the manufacturing industry. The manufacturing industry is very busy. They're currently, as you saw in the last graph, they picked up a little bit. And they're currently about 16.6% of global GDP.
まあ、金融危機というのはその生産性について考える、まあ、一つの良いきっかけだったかもしれません。生産で金融危機によって生産性が、少しだけ上がり、まあ、かつ GDP の 16% 前後をですね、マニファクチャリング業界が占めています。
Now, because the manufacturing industry is so busy and it's currently at full capacity, that's not to say necessarily that manufacturing is doing a whiz-bang job of producing goods. It's actually, it's still very inefficient. And essentially what we're looking at is an overexerted supply chain. When you go to developed economies like the U.S., like Europe, and also to a great extent in Japan, basically you see a lot of older workers that are working past retirement right now in the manufacturing shops. Many of them are already in their 60s, even in their 70s, and we're pushing them past retirement currently.
まあ、製造業っていうのがすごい忙しくて、キャパシティもフルになっているとはいえ、まあ、効率性っていうのはあまり良くないと言えます。で、例えば60歳とか70歳の引退し、まあ、仕事を引退されたご老人の方が働かれたりすることもあったりして、生産性っていう意味ではまだ改善する余地があるのかなと思っています。
Now, in addition to this $12 trillion current global manufacturing industry, Cisco is also projecting that the industrial Internet of Things industry is going to represent $4 trillion of new additional value by 2024.
はい、12兆ドルですね、のグローバルインダストリーがある中で、Cisco という会社は、新しく4兆円のですね、今後のまあ経済の変化によって、新しい、経済効果が見込まれると、想定しています。
So an interesting question to present here is we're talking about almost so hardware manufacturing of that 12 trillion is probably about half. So we're looking at almost doubling the current size of the hardware manufacturing industry in value by 2024. And where are all the resources and where is all that money?